Hi everyone, hope you all are doing good. So how you are doing? Hope you are doing good. So last few days I was like going through different Bumble threads, Bumble official community. So basically, who don't know, basically Bumble have official, you can say forum, basically Bumble forum is there, you can just check it out. You are searching the Google Bumble forum and you will get to the URL. So there is one interesting thread, just to convert the Bumble app to your native Android app. And I was thinking, oh, it will not just as like simple, let me just try it. And I tried it and I find it interesting. I don't know, but the output is not as good as I expected, but it's a pretty decent one. So and also I'm not taking credit of I just find out the new solution, or no, I'm just copying a thread from Mumble. Let me just show you the thread. And by any means, I'm not copying the whoever done the work. Let me just next dive in. There's a thread written by John Mark. So here, so we will go gonna follow this. It is pretty simple. And if you are not able to understand this, then there's a one more thread in the bottom. Then this guy is from, let's see, good. There's a one more thread is there. Yeah. I don't think so. Yeah. This one. And the same author is there. Oh, same author. Now this is thread is good. So you just have to go to. So it works for the both Android and iOS. So what the scenario is? Scenario is like you already built your Bumble app like mine. For example, I just built the app. This is the Bumble app you already built up, but now you want to upload it on the Play Store or iOS App Store. Then how you will gonna do it? So you can follow these technique to do it, and yeah, that's it. So just first of all, just go to you can, if you are building for the Android, you just click on the Android thing, click on download zip, and the zip will be downloaded and extracted it in the I already downloaded it. If you just check it out, I already downloaded it, yeah, and extracted. Now if you are building for the Android, download the Android Studio. How you will download the Android Studio? Just click on, just write down download Android Studio in the Google for whatever platform you are doing downloading. Just download the Android Studio and that's it, and install it. It will automatically automatically fetch all the libraries and all, and then download the Xcode if you are building for the iOS, and then do nothing, and then open the Android Studio. Let me just open the Android Studio. Yeah, just open the Android Studio like that, and in the create project, just open the existing project and select the location where you have just downloaded and extracted that project. So let me just go to, I think I have downloaded the downloads, and then it will be available. Yeah, this is the project, and select this one. Not this, but this one, and okay. So since I already let me just rephrase the set the Android Studio, align the Android Studio. Yeah. So basically, what you have to do just go to the RES file, go to the values, we go to the if string file. So so you have to just create one index file, and let me just show you how to like create one. So like open anything, open any text editor, whatever you have, Notepad, Notepad plus plus, like text editor in case of the Mac, or you have Atom, you have a like there's a lot of text editor. You can even search over the internet and download it, anyone, and every OS have like default text editor also. In case of Windows, it is Note plus Notepad. In case of Mac, it is a text editor. In case of Linux, there's a There is one. If you just search the text editor in the Linux, then there you need to find it. Let me just open it. Yeah, we already open one text editor. That is, I'm using Atom. I think that is default one for me. And we just need to copy and paste it. And what you need to copy, I'm just copying from the same thread that I just shared with you in the starting. Just copy the text and paste it. Yeah, this is there. And in the place of your Bumble domain, just replace the whole URL with your own URL. How you will find that URL? I'm just let me write mine first, and then I will show you how to how you can find it. Yeah, that's it. And and save it with save the please keep remember the file name, and save it with the index.json. And yes, I think we just forgot double quotes. We'll just save it again. And how you find the URL, that URL, let me just show you again. Yeah, you just need to open your project and make it preview. And copy this initial URL. But since I'm using a custom name, I think I have just copied the wrong project name. I need to just copy that name, that URL, and paste it in the same place at the URL key in the index.json file. Just save it. And what I need to do it now, go to the setting, click on SEO meta tag. Yeah, and there is an option to upload the file. Just upload the index.json file, save it. The same file that you just created, just upload it and click on the C button. And it is giving warning of the exposing file is only possible in the paid plan. We upgrade the meta tag to function to okay. So I think you need to have a paid plan to do so. But we can able to do that. We also get the URL of the index file. Now we will use that URL and add it in our Android project that we have already set up. Now go back to the Android project. Now in the Android project, just paste the that URL that you got from here and just set it. That's it. You need to click on the this button, run button. But if you are new to the Android Studio and at the very first time you have downloaded it in the Android Studio, there is a possibility you are not able to run it directly. It is disabled. So what you just need to add first add the one ADB manager, and that's it. Or you just whatever the error it shows, just copy that error and paste it to Google, and you get a lot of solution. So you don't need to worry about. And if you have any particular solution and you are not able to find over the internet, then just let me know and I will happy to help you. And just let me just shrink the screen and click on this button, and we'll run the my AD manager and we'll show the what is the output. I think it is not showing to the Intel. Let me just click the OBS. Yeah, so when you run the that project that same as like me, and then you will that emulator will run and it will show your preview. Then it will show you exact output. This is the live version of the Bumble app. The application YouTube is in the plan that has no grant. Yeah, it is done, but since I am not on paid plan for this project, so that's why it's showing error. And same for you, if you just testing out, then it is done. But if you need for your for project and something, then completely just update the app and purchase the, I think, personal plan will do. Just choose the personal plan and pay the fees, and when you check it again, it will done. And now let me tell you one more thing. For this is done for the testing purpose, but you also want to upload the APK on the Play Store. So you have to generate the signed APK. So when you go to the build, and first you need to change the package name. Just go to the build script, build.gradle, and just change the package name. Whatever you just like, it should be unique to across the all the Play Store application. So what are the best thing that I use and it will work every time? Just put down com dot project name first Android com dot Android. This is the application for Android, and then the project of the name. For example, in your case, Mumble YouTube, and yeah, and sync now. It is mandatory. You have to unique application ID for all our application. And now go to the this build.gradle file. Yeah, just check version code to one, not more than one. Sync now. And now go to the manifest file. Just change that package name also. Com dot this. Okay. Just yeah. Yeah. I think yes. It will be done. It will be done. Now you just need to build and generate signed bundled APK. So you can choose anything, Android app bundle or APK. Just to go, and now you need to create a new key store. Just click on create new and give any path. For example, in my case, I'm just giving Android downloads to downloads, and put the file name. Put the any file name, my keystore.jks work, and give the any password, and these credentials should be, you remember, like remembered it or keep it safe at any place, because this is the unique. If you forget them, you can't able to reproduce your APK. But in Bumble case, you need not to publish APK every time you changes on the Bumble app, since it is a like URL base, it will automatically change. I have not tested yet that too, but it should be. It is not. This is just a one-time thing. And you have put a any password. I'm just putting a one password. First name. Organization name, Bumble IO organization, Mumbai INC. Located Delhi, state Delhi, country IN. Okay. Yeah, I do not remember password. Don't remember password. Go to the and choose the release version. Go to the finish, and the process will be started in the bottom section. You can check it out, and it will take like I think it depends. I don't know. It's the first time. It will take some time. Yeah, it is giving in some error. Error by building Bermuda. You can find the error. Just remove that. And again, try it. Window generate, because we have changed the file name, package name now, it will create an issue. It will create an issue. Key stored password, just remember the password, export. I think we have to remove that com.json.r in the whole project. It is also unused file, that so it doesn't matter if you remove or not. Remove it. It will create an issue. I know it will create an issue. com.json build config is not. So you basically what you have to, yeah, this is the error. You have to like handle it. You have to just what you have to do, just config and choose your project. So basically our project is com.bumble app, YouTube Bumble app. So you have to search that one. Config. What do you define it? One good way also, if you just check out on the YouTube now, how to change the package name of Android, you can able to figure it out. I'm not able to figure it out right now. Why, I don't know. You need to just click on Alt or Enter in the Windows. It will automatically, if there is no other alternative, it will use the very first one. There is an error somewhere. Since we have to rename the file, we just replace the JSONet to refactor and rename, and yeah, rename package JSONet to Android and refactor. Do refactor, cannot perform the error change. Refactor, yeah, it is done. You just change the, you just put the wrong name. Just change, go again, go to the refactor, rename, rename package, go to copy paste, refactor, do refactor, done. Now just select the other one, change the seat to whatever you want to change it to. Go to refactor, rename, rename package, click on bumble.youtube, refactor, do refactor. Yeah, it is done now. Hopefully, if there is no such error there, go to the error and now let's check. Yeah, now you got them. You have to just remove all the error same. Go to the each file individually, then you have to remove the same error. I'm just doing it offline. Let me do it in a one way and then I'm just coming back. Give me 1 second. Yeah, I have fixed all there. Just go to now, just go to build, click on generate signed APK, click on app.bundle, name, next, release. Your app is bundle is created, just click on locate. This is the file. You just upload in the app play store and it's done. Done and dusted. That's it. Yeah, I hope everyone is able to understand everything. And if you have any question, any doubt, just comment it out. I'm more than happy to help you. Thank you, guys.